take. I mean, you could have an IQ of 5 and figure out how to get on StreamYard. It's just simply clicking on a link. That's it.
Five.
The genius with a 5 IQ. Now I have then I have the people that come over here and try and talk over me, Robin. I have those. So let me ask your expert opinion about what you see on IG and TikTok. What do you think of the modern women that you see on there just dancing and shaking and what are your thoughts on that? Do you think that
I think it's pornography.
It's what?
It's pornography. It's not dancing.
So what are they dancing. What are the platforms allow?
It's not
allow
dancing,
it?
It's pornography.
What does the platforms allow it?
Exactly. Why can't you give your opinion? You know? I think why I can't just you give your opinion?
Here, huh?
But you can
she had a lot to say in the room, huh?
I was trying to get on with my MacBook, but it's not letting me.
You're on. We can hear you loud and clear.
No, this is my iPad. I was trying to get on my Mac. So I had to. Oh my God! How do you work this stuff?
Empress, can you mute your YouTube? When you're in the stream, you gotta mute it. Otherwise,
my first.
You get a lot of noise.
Hold on, let me see.
When
you're in the stream, you gotta mute it.
So, Robin, you said what now?
I don't know how to work this thing. Hold on.
No, you're good, Empress. It's good.
Okay. I'm trying to block my closet. It's a mess.
Hey, Robin, you were saying? What do you think about the social media? Because I can't log on without seeing some lady dancing, showing the imprint of a pie.
Give your opinion. If you're
and then you get flag. Why?
Yeah.
Why?
I think that they must be behind it. Someone has to be behind it. Oh, I know why. Because it's considered art. I found out a secret. If you label your channel that it's art and you're expressing yourself. I found out that secret. It's art.
Come on. come on. So, Empress, you were saying some interesting things over there. You said that something about taking care of grown men. Can you speak to that, Empress?
You know, because some men are just raised differently. Some men are raised, you know, they don't really know anything about women and how to satisfy a woman and how to be respectful, you know? So it's not really what you were saying about communism. A lot of people don't even know what that means.
Well, so
if you don't know what it means, then it can't really affect you. You just move in how you was taught, you know?
From what do you mean it can't affect you? So is that really true? If I don't know what it means, it can affect me? So
yeah, because you're not really walking in that path. You know, you're just going your daily lives about how you was raised by your mom or your grandmother or your parents or whatever it is.
So, okay, so let me ask you this. Let me give you a different perspective, right?
Okay.
All right. So let's say I have an agenda to abort all black babies. Right? Let's say I just thought abortion was okay, right? But every time
that's what you're thinking personally?
What's that?
That's what you're thinking personally?
No, I'm giving you an example because you don't seem to understand the other one. You said if you don't know, it can affect you, right?
Right.
So let's say this. Like, I was a physician, right? And you come in and, you know, I'm your gynecologist, right? And so I have an agenda to abort all black babies, right? So when you come into my office, I prick you with something that's going to cause an abortion. You don't, you're not aware of it. You don't know what it means, but
if you're a physician, you know exactly what that means.
No, you're not. You're not. You're missing it. You're not really listening to me.
What are you saying?
You're going into a physician, right?
Okay.
Because you said that if someone doesn't know what something means, it can affect them, right? But I'm showing you that it can, right? So you could be going into the physician. You don't know that the physician is injecting you with something that's going to cause an abortion. Okay. Right? So just because you're unaware does not mean that it cannot affect you, right? So just because, like, let's say women that behave in a certain way, just pushing feminism, right? Just saying, I want to be single. They don't believe that that's affecting them, but it really is in long terms, right? Because first of all, most of those women that's pushing that, they have a medium salary. And so they don't think of the long-term effect that may have, right? Because if you're only earning $50,000, that's not something you're going to be able to survive off in your elderly age, right? And if you, like, just base it on the average promotion that a person receives over a lifetime. So in order for a single woman that has that sort of mindset to survive in her old age, she would have to be with another man. And the same thing with a man that's making somewhere around that salary. See, it may not immediately affect you, but people don't really have any kind of perception of the long-term effect that these things have. And they don't see how that kind of, like, brings about, as I was stating earlier, when you research European societies, every European nation in the world is below zero population growth. And why? It's because they embrace the agenda of independent women, right? But now it's coming back to haunt them. They embrace the agenda of working on your career, don't worry about children now. So now Pat Buchanan, he wrote that book, Death of the West, and he say, when he wrote that book, every European nation, except for one, was below zero population growth. That means more Europeans was dying than they was giving birth to, right? So it was an older society. And so his prediction back then was that within 50 years, blacks and Hispanics will outnumber Europeans in America. And this was at least 15 years ago. So then he came back with a call, Death of a Superpower. And he said now all European nations are below zero population growth. And the things that was contributing to that was women not wanting to get married anymore, women not wanting to have children and working on their careers. He said those were some of the number one factors, but it's coming back to hurt them in the end because he said America is becoming more browner and browner. And so he says if this same system keeps up, then the brown people's going to determine who's going to be in office and who's going to run America. So he's saying they don't realize the effects that it has on them. So they're not thinking that, I'm sure, but the social scientists and the people that deal with demography are thinking of that. So while they're saying, oh, no, it's really affecting them in the long term, it's going to affect their children, is what I'm saying. They may not get to see it, but their children and their grandchildren will get to see the effects of it.
The effects of what, women wanting to be single?
Yes. Because that, not with the single agenda, also comes a lot of women that don't want to be impregnated, that don't want to be reproductive. Do you know a lot of single women that want to have children and not want to be with a man?
No, not really.
Yeah.
Everyone that I know is either married or with children or, single with children. But sometimes
Most of those single women want to be alone, raising those children alone.
Yes, they do. Some of them do. That's their preference because they can't bother dealing with the negativity and the stress of being with a man. A man comes with a lot.
So, have you looked at the impacts of single women that don't want to deal with the stress of being with a man?
Yeah.
Have you looked at the impacts that have on children?
On the children, yes. I've seen the impact, but sometimes it's good to be single, you know, because you don't know what the mentality of the man. You don't know what is he bringing.
How is that good for the children?
Huh?
How is that good for the children?
Because sometimes the relationship or the man is so toxic that it affects the child's mentality.
Okay, so you believe that every relationship that a woman leaves is because a man is toxic?
No, I'm not saying that because the man is toxic. Sometimes she just feels like she can provide a more healthier, progressive environment and life for, you know, the environment and the children and herself.
So I just asked you, have you looked at the statistics on that? Because the facts show otherwise.
No, I have no statistics. It's just like me personal. It's my personal opinion and my thoughts and what I see.
Okay, but we're talking about realistic things right here, how they're actually impacting children. Mm-hmm. Do you know that studies show that children raised by single women are more prone? They have a much higher suicide rate. They have a much higher teenage pregnancy rate. They have a much higher substance and alcohol abuse rate. They have a much higher problems in school, dropping out of school.
Yeah, but who are we to believe what statistics say? I mean, look at the COVID situation that just came through. I mean, everybody was going off of statistics, numbers, and all of these stuff.
Everything
that you see and read, and
that's a poor analogy.
True.
That's a poor analogy because we can see it in society. See, we don't have to speculate on something like COVID. We can see this in society. Do you know that 90% of people in prison was raised by a single woman? Did you know that?
No, I didn't know that.
Yeah, so we can see this in society.
I would think so, yeah, but I didn't know that. But yeah.
No, it's a fact. It's a fact. You talk to most people that's in prison, the father wasn't in their life.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. And so also when people that's like that has personality disorders, most of those people have been proven to raise by single mothers. People that's on substance abuse, there's a much higher percentage of those people that didn't have a father in their life. But let me give you this. On the reverse, single fathers, statistically, and society doesn't like to admit this, does just a good of a job as both parents.
If he's mentally stable and strong for that.
I think you're speaking from an emotional perspective.
No, he has to be prepared. These things have been proven again and again. He has to be raised right. Not any man can take care of a child if he's not mentally stable and strong.
Okay, but I'm citing you things that's actually taken place. It's been proven over and again.
By whom? You're saying if he's healthy.
Right?
But studies have shown that
there's way far more men that raise healthier children than the single woman.
I don't agree with that.
It doesn't matter whether you agree with it. It doesn't change the truth.
But what is the truth?
The truth is that studies have shown again and again that children that's raised by a single father are highly more probable to go to college and be successful in life, and they contribute more back to society than the single mother raised children. That those studies show again and again. And it's not that difficult to pull those up.
No, I mean, I've been hearing stuff about that and seeing things on the internet, but.
But I mean, you don't even have to look at that. You could literally go from home to home and you could look at it. You could look at children that's raised by a single man compared to a single woman. And so I could almost guarantee you most of the men that you're complaining about was raised by a single woman. Almost guarantee it. Most of the men that you're saying that you don't like, the same agenda that you're trying to promote, you're really against, and you don't even realize it. Because most of those men that you're saying that have these issues were raised by single women. Because men that's raised by men that know how to be men, they don't behave the same way.
Right.
They just don't behave this. And I could tell that when a lot of guys come to this core, one of the first things I ask them when he gets overly emotional, mm-hmm. I say, was your father in your life? And he starts stuttering. And he doesn't want to answer that question. And now, what does it got to do with anything? It has a lot to do with everything, brother. Look how you're conducting yourself. And I see it again and again. And those guys, those men, because they don't have that role, that male role model to like really emulate and keep in balance and on a center. So these kind of men, they act real bitchy. They argue with women a lot. They get overly emotional. But when you look back,
single mom.
Most of the time, their fathers weren't in their lives.
Wasn't in their lives.
He wasn't there.